Alright, so here we go. Round two. Yeah, now round one. Because they fucked me over. I don't know, maybe I'm just dumb and I can't hit record. So, hold that last one again. Well, here, we'll just say this right quick. Pretty quick. Let me turn this off. Now that we get eternal music. Oh. No, that's pretty good. Like, yeah, but something's wrong. Like, anyway, so. So, remember way back in, 9-11, I'm at the fucking video arcade, last cast, I'm waking up, I'm drunk, smoking weed, because like the year before I was smoking weed at college for the first time, and then came home. I don't remember. Anyway, so like I go to work, and then like no one was at the mall, and I go into the mall, and I'm hearing the Who, so I'm like, there's no one around. I'm like, well, there shouldn't be anyone around because it's the beginning of the day, but there's really no one around. Like the movie theater isn't. And the Who says, they didn't. No one had the guts to leave the temple. Right as I walk in to my job at Aladdin's Castle. I wanted to be the greatest Tekken warrior ever. I played King and Anna. Nina was a bitch. Anna was a badass. She was like stack hard, rock solid. Nina was like too flirty and too quick. But Nina was fucking hard. You know, Tekken. You know, I'm talking about like King. Like, you know, I liked wrestling when I was younger. Okay, so that's the video arcade. 9-11. What did I say last time? Alright, so let me tell you about this story. So, man of mine, he was a blacksmith. He was an iron worker. He rolled in the tires. Like, he burnt tires. He collected old tires to put in his fire so he could roll his iron ore. He was a blacksmith by training. He was a hard ass motherfucker. Motherfucker. This blacksmith was a hard ass. Okay? And he had, well, like, you know, he did things for the city people around town. Like, you know, golden gloves in the midst of, like, a technological, iron, rock solid iron proportion. Like, you know, people that like didn't like couldn't pick up like the Jarvix Cube Census 3400, like, you know, they didn't have the strength, so like this ironclad man, fucking blacksmith, would like weld him up fucking a super Titan arm so he could pick up the Jarvix Cube 3530. Whatever it was. And so, like, yeah. So, like, well, this blacksmith guy. He built a new arm. Well, he got tired of building people's new arms. Because he's like, it's too complicated. Like, you know, really? Like, it really stresses me out, like, when I don't get something right. And, like, there's really little tiny technical things. It, like, really pisses me off. I get, like, really stressed. And, like, really, doctor? Like, I don't know why, like, I would try to explain it to someone else. But, like, I don't even want to explain it to someone else. I just know how to do it. And, like, these people, like, keep asking me, give me a Titan arm. And then the doctor said, well, take some of these and you'll be ready to go in the morning. And then the blacksmith was like, alright, buddy. So he took the little pills and he was making his Titan motherfucking amputee arms, and like, I made an amputee pineal gland. And he started going away like on the electric iron metal calibrations and like dictated like the ways that needed to be fucking happening, so the iron mech pineal gland would super flare out into the universe and take over the entire world. And so then the blacksmith who took like all the medication that like he died, you know, he was making freaking metal arms for people to pick up iron trucks and like alabaster crates of many different marble statues of many tons of weights. And when he saw his doctor, like, yeah, this guy, like, he fucking does some shit. So he gave him some good pills, right? But did I tell you about how after he gave him the pills, like, the blacksmith, like, made them a super mech pineal gland? See, that's where he went too far. I mean, he was a talented blacksmith, but then when he went to, like, duplicate the pineal gland, the blacksmith fucking went too far. That's all I'm saying. That's all I'm saying, guys, okay? Just go back to your roots. Enjoy a nice spring breeze. Smell the flowers. Take a nature walk. Play guitar, mandolin, if you're a faggot, you know. And just do your thing, you know. Just don't, trust me, don't make mechanized pineal glands. Blacksmith douche, don't even talk to me. All right, I'll just leave it at that.